Welcome to r/entitledpeople, where we share stories from your lives about people who think the rules don't apply to them and they should get what they want. Thank you, friends, for subscribing to the channel and for so many likes. The first story. Remember, all the money in the world can't save you from a diuretic horse. The second story. Pratt tries to park on my parents' drive, gets taught a lesson. The third story. Shut up an annoying important guy from a large company with one application. The first story is My Granddad the Horse, the Spoiled Brat, and the Soap Injection. The cast of this little SH storm, and trust me, that's a very descriptive term for what's to come. GD, Granddad, hard worker till the day he died, salt of the earth sort of man, who doesn't stand for SH off anyone. CW, coworker, friend of GD and worked with him in this story. SB, spoiled B, daughter of the farm who got exactly what was coming to her. Horse, a horse, the hero every farmhand needs. When my granddad was a young man, he lived near a large farm, and like many young men across the ages, he liked to go for a drink now and then and date the lasses on the side. This was before he met my nan, but unfortunately all of this is impossible without money. He sure as sugar wasn't going to ask his own father for money, and he knew for a fact that even if he did, he wouldn't get anything. So him and his friend decided, like many others, to head up to the local farm and get work there. These are the days where agriculture was king, and the farmer made the most money out of anyone else in the village. Not rich per se, but most produce in the village came from that farm, and considering he grew barley for the brewery in Sheffield Center, as well that included some of the beer brands in the pubs, so I suppose you could call him moderately wealthy. I don't know if he had a wife, as GD told me very little, other than this about him, but he seemed like a nice enough man. He had one large flaw though, spoiled B. SB was renowned in the village where Granddad grew up as being a nasty piece of work. She flaunted her father's money around and wore expensive dresses and shoes, buying them the moment they were released in the local clothes shops. Like I said, they were only moderately wealthy. GD hated her. And unfortunately, seeing as he worked on the farm, he had to put up with her a fair bit, as she often patrolled the grounds to feel like she was in charge, which is where the entitlement came into it. GD ignored her for the most part. SB thought her word was law on the farm, and the workers, whom she thought peasants, had to obey her without question. FYI, they didn't. GD was an odd job sort of man at the farm. He was a mechanic, so could fix machines, but good with animals, so he often helped out with them as well. Even helping with the horses, which he enjoyed as he liked horses. But there was one thing that he despised about working with the horses, but had to do for their own health, and that was a soap injection. Now, I'm not certain whether this was exaggerated by him, or if this is an outdated veterinarian practice, but basically it involved getting a bar of special soap and a large glove that covered your arm. Pretty sure you can see where this is going. And inserting it up the horse's rear exit. Yeah, it's bad, but without it, the horses could get sick, and he didn't want that, so he bit the bullet and had to do it. Plus, it paid extra. The soap, a medical name for it, was made to loosen up the horse's bowels and clean the inside so it stayed healthy. That being said, after you've given a horse a soap injection, you get far away from that horse. And if you're wondering why, then you need to carefully reread this paragraph. So it was a sunny day, and GD had just given a horse its injection and had sprinted back to the fence post where CW was waiting for him. They had nothing else to do for a while, so GD lit his pipe, and CW lit his, and they just puffed away for a while. Enter SB. She came marching up to the two of them in one of her fancy dresses and a sun hat, and asked why they weren't working. GD ignored her and went on puffing away, so she went into the field and went up to the horse. GD, don't go near him, lass. SB, what? GD, don't go near that horse. He's just had... SB, I can do what I want. It's my father's farm and I'm in charge round here. CW, but lass, the thing's just had its... GD stopped him talking and settled in where he sat on the fence. He told me as he sat he was praying in the back of his mind that what he hoped would happen. It did. The horse had the injection. The soap had just taken effect. The horse was facing away from her as she marched up. What happened next was both inevitable and one of the few things that has made GD laugh out loud in his life. The horse lifted its tail, and either it was scared because SB had marched up behind it, which GD mentioned you should never do if you wanted to trust it, or it couldn't hold it in anymore. Or, and I like to think this, it knew exactly who was behind it, and exactly what it was doing. Promptly let out a tremendous spray of SH. SB, who was behind it at the time, didn't get struck fully on, but the spray was enough to cover her new dress in brown specks and catch her face. Like GD said, stay far away from the horse, and her shoes got splattered by the bulk of the projectile. She screamed like a banshee and staggered back, getting the back of her dress splattered in the process and almost slipping in the muck on the ground. She staggered back crying and screaming, while GD and CW laughed like anything. GD laughed so hard he spat back through his pipe, making it puff like a steamship. SB stormed over and screamed they had done it on purpose and that they were fired. GD and CW just laughed and walked off to their next job, and that night both of them were gleefully telling everyone what they had saw, and SB became the target of mockery whenever she opened her mouth for a good few months after that, and whenever she tried to brag after about the topic would come up once more. The second story is, family assume my driveway is a free parking spot. This happened to me a few years ago. I had recently moved to the north of Scotland, where I now live, and was staying with my mom and stepdad while getting a house sorted. They went away on holiday for a fortnight, so missed all the fun. I came home from work one afternoon, started at 400 and finished at 1330, to find a car blocking the driveway into my house. Having a small car, I parked at the top of the drive, blocking them in. My parents live out in the sticks on a single-track road, so I couldn't leave my car where it was, because I would have been blocking the road. After an hour, I saw someone approaching the drive and taking pictures of my car. I went out and confronted them, and the conversation went like this. Me, why are you taking pictures of my car? EP, because you parked illegally, blocking my car in. I'm gonna call the police if you don't move your car from my neighbor drive. Me, this is my clearly parents' drive. Did you not think it was odd having to walk out of someone's garden to get in a neighbor? EP, well, it wasn't very clear, so can you move so I can get out? So I get my keys and move, and then park my car and think nothing of it. Next morning I leave for work and once again I find the same car parked in my parents' drive. This time I go knock on my neighbor's door and ask him to get his friend to shift it. Only for my neighbor to ask what friend. I pointed to the car and told him what had happened yesterday. Turns out the Pratt wasn't his friend at all, but liked to walk around the woodland path near our houses. 20 minutes later he finally appears, smirks and moves before saying, EP, I'll be parked here tomorrow too. So once again I go to work at stupid o'clock, and when I get back, lo and behold, the Pratt is parked there again. This time I decided to teach him a lesson. I had 2 days off, so I went to the shops and got some shopping, and a rather large amount of alcohol. Strongbow and Savannah Dry Cider if you're interested. Got home, parked as close to his car as I could, making sure I was safely off the road. I went inside, made some dinner and started drinking. About an hour later, there's banging on the door. Me, yes? EP, move your car. It's blocking me in and my family want to go home. I look out and there's his rather embarrassed looking family sitting in their car. Me, sorry, can't. As I took another drink from my cider. Been drinking for a couple of hours. Probably over the limit, so I don't want to risk it. EP, what? Why are you drinking when you knew I'd be wanting to move my car? Me, I'm off for the next 2 days, so I fancy to drink. EP, I'm calling the effing police. Me, you do that. Before shutting the door and popping into the lounge to watch TV, while also watching them through the window. About 2 hours, apparently the police had trouble finding my house, haha. Later, the police arrive and speak to EP before they knock on my door. Me, yes officer, how can I help you? PO1, why are you stopping EP from leaving? So I began explaining the events of the previous days, and mentioned how I told him he couldn't park here. I also explained that I had been drinking, and was probably over the limit, so I couldn't risk moving my car. PO1 and 2 agreed that I was correct to not drive while intoxicated. They then asked what insurance I had. I pointed out that it was name driver only, basically means that only people whose name is on the insurance can drive my car, so they couldn't move it for me. EP, come on, just make him move his car. PO2, just gonna get the breathalyzer. Blow into this, please, to me. You're about 2 times the legal limit, so I'm sorry, but you can't move your car. PO1 to EP, sorry, but he's over the limit. You'll have to leave your car here and come back tomorrow. EP, what? But how are we meant to get home? Me, bus stop about 2 miles down that road. You'll get the bus to insert city at this time or insert town at this time. EP, but the bus doesn't go anywhere near where we live. PO2, we can call you a taxi if you want, but you'll need to pay for it. EP, he did this deliberately. Me, yup. Fast forward to the next day. The police arrive with him in their car, and before they ask me to move my car, they decided to have some fun. PO1, we just want to check you with the breathalyzer again. Big deep breath. EP, looking more and more worried. PO2, you're fine, can you move your car please? Me, of course officers. PO1 to EP, Don't park your car here again. EP couldn't even look at me, just got in his car and drove off. Later that day, I decided to build a gate for my parents. And the last story is, I know, I installed it. IT guy here, worked in the field for almost 25 years, and now I'm considered a global expert in my specialty. I'm one of the people who made sure that anything on the internet was permanent and had a hand in building a major cloud service. In the early 2000s, I was already considered an expert and was asked by my employer to present about a product at a bank who had just purchased it. I was part of a team with two other guys. Each of us was going to give a technical presentation to the IT department. The first guy had been talking for about 5 minutes when someone entered the room and things started going downhill. He was heckling us. Well, when I was at Insert Major Retailer, we had problems with that and blah blah blah. The guy had the most annoying nasal snide voice, just dripping with I'm going to blather on about how smart I am by putting you down. God, I wanted to punch him, but even worse, I had to do my presentation in front of him. Maybe he'd stop after the first guy was finished. Oh no, he didn't. The next guy got up, talking about a different but related product and its technical features, and he laid into him. Well, Insert Major Retailer had so much trouble with ISCSI that we had to blah blah blah. Oh, wonderful. What I didn't notice was how other people in the room were reacting to him. He was getting the side eye, ESADMF look, the blatant glares from all the IT guys there. In retrospect, why the manager there didn't shut him up is still a mystery. So when my turn came, I decided to just plow through things and endure him. I started talking about my product, and sure enough, he had to say something. Well, at Insert Major Retailer, we had one of these, and it gave us a lot of trouble with authenticating into Windows domain servers. This was before Active Directory came out. Not relevant to the story, but it gives the tech folks an idea of when. I stood there and listened to him, just nodding along. I can field this one, no sweat. I know, I installed it. Dead silence. The OS was about 3.2 or 3.3, I think. I went on, not realizing what had happened. Now we're on version 6, and if I remember right, it was a Windows authentication issue and worked perfectly after a patch. 2 seconds later, it hit me. OSH, I just shut down the client, but I continued on with my presentation, and he left shortly afterwards before I finished. All the IT guys came up and apologized, telling me he'd just come over from Insert Major Retailer and couldn't stop talking about how they did things and why it was better. One guy said he was an A and they couldn't stand him. Outside the bank, everyone was laughing and congratulating me for shutting him down, saying he'd stepped in it and stepped in it good. We were almost at lunch when we met the sales guy, who had been on the phone, and the first thing he asked was, "Who's Joe, not my name?" "Me," I replied, not certain how this was going to go, but he shook my hand. That was effing brilliant. I was so mad at that jerk, and when you shut him down, I jumped up and started punching at the phone, yelling, "Yes, yes, yes! Take that, a-hole!" I've told that story over and over since. It never gets old and never has happened again. I honestly don't want it to. I'm a professional that takes great pride in my work, and he was the total opposite of one. It speaks volumes of their hiring practices that they let someone like that get through. I hope you enjoyed the video. Hit the like button and don't forget to subscribe and turn on notifications.